Da una mia serra, che dai, come on! Non fammi. Why, we are afraid. What for?
Oppure saranno tutti cantanti con quelle vicine piccole, 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 tipo Moscerino, che faranno poi tutto, faranno Norma, faranno Aida, faranno il barbiere di Siviglia, la Bohème, ma sempre con queste vocine piccoline che non avranno personalità e naturalmente non sentiranno più le composizioni come il compositore le ha create, come le ha volute, assolutamente.
And so, you know, I'm going to the Met and I'm watching performances and I'm seeing all these tenors, you know, Jerry Hadley, Neil Wilson, Keith Olsen. They're all tearing it up at the Met. And I'm like, and I keep asking, who's training these guys? same name kept coming up, Tom LaMonaco, Tom LaMonaco. I'm like, who? Tom LaMonaco. This is the guy I'd read about in Opera News that Jerry told me about. So I called Tommy, the biggest teacher in New York, you know, the biggest tenor trainer in New York. I'm thinking, if he even takes my call, maybe he'll see me in like 3 months. And he's like, oh, yeah, you're the guy that Jerry told me was going to call. I said, yeah, that's me. I'd love to come and sing for you. Yeah, I'd love to, you know, see what you think. I'd love to be part of the studio. And he says, and I'm at work, and he goes, great. He says to me, why don't you come over at, how's 3 o'clock? And I'm like, I did like a Ralph Kramden. I'm like, I couldn't even talk. I was like, 3 o'clock, what, today? So I went over, I sang a horribly terrified rendition of Que Jelly de Manina, you know, first act aria from La Boheme. Yep. He goes, what do you want to sing, lad? He called everybody lad. I said, all right, I want to sing the first act aria from La Boheme. He goes, all right, go ahead, whenever you're ready. Then I went, Que Jelly de Manina. I did, that's what I sang. Because that's what I thought I heard on the album. C'est la la, she discalzon, je ricorde que je... It was real musical. It was real pretty. It was about this big. And Tom, first thing I saw him do was lean forward. I was like, oh, God, he can't hear me over the piano. I'm getting out of here. I'm going back to Watertown. That's it. I'm done. I'm over. And Tommy was like, listen, you know, you're one of the most musical guys that's ever come to sing for me. He goes, your interpretation was beautiful. Your use of the phrasing was beautiful. Your voice is horribly underdeveloped. And I went, wait. First he was, you know, complimenting me, and then he slid that one in. I'm like, underdeveloped? What do you mean? I don't understand. And I really didn't. I had no concept. And, you know, this will never come through, you know, over a Skype interview, but Tom took me over. He said, come over here. And Tom, now remember, Tom was about 60, I don't know, late 60s by this point. He says, do me a favor. Imitate me. He goes over the piano, plays a G, and he goes like this. Make this sound for me, okay? And he's 2 feet from my face. And he goes like this. Make this sound for me. He goes... He goes, do that for me. I went, no, that's not possible. And I had the images of, like, you know, blood spray pattern on the walls and my cords flying out of my throat. And he goes, come on, lad, make that sound. And this went on for like an hour. And, you know, obviously I couldn't make the sound, but I did the best I could. And that was my introduction to Tom. He's like, listen, you want to sing for 2,000 people, 3,000 people, whatever. He says, no microphone. You know, you need to, you want to train like all the guys you go to the opera right now to see? This is how we do it. And within 6 months, I'm seeing Jerry Hadley now, the guy who gave me the introduction, these guys who I'm idolizing on TV, coming out when I'm walking in and walking in when I'm going out. And I'm in there working with Tom, you know, taking lessons. And he goes, hey, you know who's waiting for a lesson after you? Jerry Hadley's here. And then he goes, Jerry, come on in here. I want you to hear this kid. And he gets Jerry to come into the studio. He goes, you remember this guy? This is the guy that you brought in from Watertown. And Jerry was like, yeah. And all of a sudden, Tom's like, sing here, lad. And he wants me to sing, like, I'll sing like a phrase from Aida or something, to high B flat or whatever. And then suddenly Jerry and I are going out to lunch.
Wow.
I'm meeting all these people. And that's basically the story. Tommy kept me in the studio for about 5 years.
Wow.
Wouldn't let me sing. I never sang a note at home. Didn't sing in between. I worked at this video store 65 hours a week to be able to afford 3 lessons a week with Tom. And that was my life. That's all I did.
The typical radio singer does not possess these two basics. The sings with a technique which is in between them. He uses mixed falsetto. I'm going to ask Miss Eddie to illustrate this mixed falsetto singing to you. I'll first have him sing a little bit of a tune in his real voice. Then I'll have him sing it in the mixed falsetto, standing at a distance from the microphone. Last, I'll have him sing it close up, just as the radio crooner does. So we'll change the order so that you can compare them. We'll first sing it in the mixed falsetto, away from the microphone.
Thank you. sembra stato.